I went to the beach the other day. I had a lot of fun, actually. I was taking this little camcorder here, and I was actually very impressed with how it turned out. That got me thinking even a little bit more, and I started to think about, does resolution actually matter? Does the sheer amount of megapixels in a camera or device matter? Now, of course, the trendy answer in the YouTube video is to say, no, you don't need more resolution. Nah, you can just get whatever camera you want. And yeah, I mean, like, yeah, but I think that people don't really explain why they think that. And I'm gonna fix that right now. I'm gonna explain why I think that maybe it's a little bit more complicated than yes or no. This was my first, like, real dedicated camera that I've been using for a little while. It is absolutely tiny. The lens itself basically blocks the whole thing. I mean, it's great. I actually had to switch the lens off of it with the one that I had on it, the kit lens, because it was literally so big that you couldn't see the rest of the camera underneath it. But great camera, NEX5R. It has 16 megapixels in its sensor. A little bit more, 16 point something, I don't know. It takes great photos. I mean, I've never really had an issue with it. The last real big trip that I took with it before I got a new one was San Francisco. And that was an absolute joy to shoot, even with its compact size, or maybe because of it, I was able to take such incredible street photography, at least by my own personal standards, that I think that was probably one of my favorite trips I've ever taken, just because of the quality of images that I was able to take. Because it was such a small sensor, such a small device, I was able to bring it basically anywhere I wanted. Again, it is absolutely tiny. It is crazy how much camera you get in this little thing. But of course, I did eventually want an upgrade because I wanted a viewfinder, I wanted something more. So of course, I went for something still used, but a little bit higher quality, which was the Fujifilm X-T1. And you know, it has a viewfinder, it's way more premium, it's an all metal body, you know, you have these little dials on the top. I've talked about this in previous videos. It actually has the same amount of megapixels. And yet I consider the images that come out of this camera clearer, more refined, and in my opinion, better. I'm not gonna claim that I thought resolution was gonna fix everything, because if it was, and if I did think that, then I wouldn't be picking this camera. I think it was interesting just how much clarity is really not affected by the megapixel count. It's really affected by a whole ton of other factors in the camera. And then that leads us to today, which is when I was using that little camcorder right here. Dude, it literally has megapixel on the front of this thing, okay? That is, it's on DVDs, man. And yet I find the images so compelling, and I find it really visually pleasing in a way that perhaps I wouldn't really get with the NEX5R. So what sets it apart? What is so important to me? Right now, it's color. Color is pretty much everything. Despite being an absolute newbie at color grading, doing all this kind of stuff, when it comes to photos, I love tweaking color. It's my favorite thing in the world, and I think that's what people should focus on instead of simply resolution. And to be honest with you, even when it comes to situations where you may want that extra resolution, so for example, this giant vista right here, which was a beautiful beach shot, I love this picture, you don't actually need like that much resolution, if you understand what I'm saying here. Obviously there is a draw to being able to take a giant 80 megapixel image with a giant medium format sensor that's shockingly clear, even if you blow it up to the size of your wall. But there's a lot of disadvantages to using something like that, where, for example, there are larger file sizes, so you need bigger storage cards, SD cards, all that kind of stuff. It's more file, so your processor on the camera has to basically chug a little harder to be able to process it all. It actually will add up and fill up your hard drive, all that kind of stuff. Your computer has to be able to process that kind of image too. It's just a lot of extra steps here that I think people kind of overlook. I love shooting RAW, I love shooting JPEGs, all these things, and they all have their place. But I think that it can be very easy to get swept up in the sheer technical values that kind of come up when you're discussing buying a new camera or using your camera or all that kind of stuff. Resolution is not the be-all, end-all to quality. That is so important to remember here. And to be fair, you know, a 60 megapixel camera is absolutely a little bit below the average nowadays. You're going to get your 20 megapixel, 24 megapixel. The latest flagships are like 40 megapixel cameras. And they're that high for a reason. They actually allow you to crop in, to reframe your image completely, and you know, do stuff that you otherwise would not be able to do with, for example, a 60 megapixel image. And that's fine. That's 100% fine. That's 100% has its use case, especially if you aren't able to reframe the shot when you're physically there. But I think that when you're starting out as a photographer, it is so important to be able to develop that sense for framing and that ability to literally put yourself in that position and hit that shot in person. Of course, if you have some kind of disability, if you're unable to physically get that shot, then of course, by all means, go for it. It's absolutely a tool that needs to be used. You know, you deserve to use it. I'm not going to deny that. But I think if you have that physical ability, it's definitely a way to train that muscle when you basically cannot crop in because you have to get there. Some of the most memorable shots that I've taken come from me not being able to reframe. Me not being able to adjust in post. I have to nail it then and there. I remember being in San Francisco and trying to hit that shot and sometimes encountering other people with cameras who are doing the same thing as me. And there's that shared experience, right, of the mind's eye attempting to translate what it's getting in the real world into a piece of art. And that's so special. And when you're first starting out, I think it's 100% experience you need to get yourself, challenging yourself just a little bit. This is also why I recommend, you know, prime lenses and stuff like that, because you are aiming for a certain focal length and you need to work with that. Constraint creates good art. Restrictions create good art. Having to challenge yourself to create your desired outcome and perhaps even compromise a little. And, you know, get those different types of solutions that you otherwise would never even encounter or think of. That is so much more important than sheer technical specs. I actually think it's a really good exercise to use a lower spec camcorder or something that's cheaper or older or something and experimenting with it. Because it is in itself a constraint, but that doesn't mean it's bad. That just means it's different than what you have right now. It was incredibly fun to shoot with this camcorder when it wasn't deleting all of my video for the day because it decided to format itself again. That kind of sucked. But aside from that, it's great. It's fun. And you know, if you apply a little bit of a color grade on top, not too much, just a little bit of an adjustment, it can look downright cinematic. At least in my opinion. I'm kind of a beginner in terms of cinematography and videography, all that kind of stuff. I'm not going to claim I'm good at that. But it's fun. It's really fun. And I think that's what this hobby is all about. You're supposed to have fun taking pictures. And when you gotta like cross the street, when you gotta like climb a fence, when you gotta like sit on like the second floor of a building and like hang off of it. I've never done that, but I would do that. It creates these memories that you're never gonna forget because that's what's important. That's what's important is doing it. It's not doing it on your laptop afterwards. It's doing it in person. Do it in person. Unless you can't, then, you know, obviously, whatever. When you get your giant, beautiful 80 megapixel camera in the future, off of all the money that you made selling your pictures or whatever, or taking wedding photography, doing all that kind of stuff, just remember me. Just remember this little video and toss me a like. Maybe subscribe if you want. And think of me. Okay? Thank you. Thank you. All right, I'm just kidding. But I would appreciate a little subscribe. Like, if you want, maybe a comment, perhaps too. It feeds me. Thank you.